Hi friends, this is Sudhir Kove, and today we are going to do the analysis of Sushant Singh Rajput's signature. So I was delaying this analysis because I felt very bad, because it's like, you know, he was living the dream which we all wanted to live, a common man, common boy, or a boy from a middle class family, reaching to something very unique and very great in the life of the actor. No, it was a kind of shock. So I was not willing to speak, but then I thought, you know, let's speak about it. Let other people also know what happens when you have that kind of signature. What exactly must have happened, and what is this the signature means? I hope it's visible to you all. So this is what the signature of Sushant Singh Rajput. So first thing which you observe whenever you, if you're watching the signature, the first thing which is there in the signature of Sushant Singh Rajput is what? Is this angle. S has angle. So if you are not aware about graphology, what this S means? This S means that this is the upper part of the S is about you being able to speak. You know, you are speaking about something, maybe sympathy, maybe compassion. So this S is basically for that, you know. So the top portion of S is for speaking, your ability to speak about you being sympathetic, you being generous, you being helpful to other people. So the moment this S becomes this kind of angular, if you see this S is has a lot of angle. So this angle means discomfort. So the moment you have this kind of angle in the S, it's difficult for you to speak now. So even you must have seen the way he uses interviews and all, his mouth was not fully open all the time. Okay, he was not speaking with his mouth open. So now, because you have this kind of vibrations, now it's difficult for other people to come to you and speak as well. Because what you are going to give to the universe is what you are going to get from the universe. So when you are at discomfort with other people while speaking, then similar thing will also happen to you. So people will avoid speaking with you. People will not come to speak with you, you know, because you have this vibration. There is nobody else, you know. Whatever is happening in your life is because of your own perception. If your perception is different, your life will be different. Now, whatever life you are living right now is because you have that kind of perception towards life, and that is what life is serving to you. If you think life differently, yesterday I was talking to two guys, both are in construction area, both are builders or architect, you know, some similar kind of thing. So when I spoke to builder said his business is growing now. Why? Because a lot of people wants to have their own independent house, and not they don't want to live in the Jhopapatti or slum. So his mindset is now people business is going to grow. So in lockdown also he has got the money, his business is successful. Whereas the person who is into architect, what he spoke that he is going to get a lot of struggle. Why? Because you need to accept the facts. So the facts are facts till the time you accept them as a fact. If you are not aware, it was a challenge for a lot of people to run 100 meters race within 10 seconds. It was difficult for them. But you know what? Once one person did it, after that, it got broken 200 times. All of a sudden, within a span of 6 months, 200 people came who were able to run 100 meters within 10 seconds. First double century in cricket happened after so many years. But you know what? Once it happened, the record got broken several times. You know, so many people have already done it. So it's all about the mindset. It's all about the thinking. So whatever perception you have about the life, similar thing is what you are going to get in your life. So this person is going to have the first problem is about speaking to other people about sympathy. And the other people will find difficult to speak to him about the sympathy as well. So this is the first thing. Then the second thing which I see is over here is the dot. Okay, so this dot particularly, what it shows that the moment you put a dot in signature, it shows a wall. It is a kind of wall between you and other world. So this is a wall. So when you put a wall, it's like you are isolating yourself from the rest of the world. So the people, see, it's not a bad character. It's not a good character. It depends. Let's assume you are in a government office where you are not supposed to disclose many things to other people. Then this dot is good. This dot will help you to isolate you from other people so that you will not reveal things to people. But if you are in a field where you need to connect, you would need to be with the people, then this dot is not good. So this dot will help you to isolate yourself from other people. So you will be not doing communication with other people. Now, another thing which you observe, this is a very particular, you know, is like nobody must have seen this. This particular line is going up and this line is going down on the similar path. So it's like if you have this kind of S, this is called as the extra responsibility S. If a person has a kind of S where there is a formation of loop, then the person is taking an extra responsibility. Now, what happens in terms of this signature? It's like this S is having the retrace formation. So this person will take the extra responsibility of some people and he will come under stress. It will be difficult for him to withstand to that responsibility. So I was just reading about him and I understood that a few of his friends had left the job to support him to do a research in his acting role, you know, in his movies role research. So this is the kind of thing which will, after some months, because he was not getting enough support from the film industry, there is a chance that he might feel stress about the similar thing of taking the responsibility of other people. So this is what that thing is. And then at the dot mill, again, the separation. Then when you try to see the remaining part of it, you know, this is the way he has written Rajput. So you see this formation and this formation going down. Okay, this is the way he is writing it. So now when you have this kind of R written over here, this is a huge, huge loop in R. Too huge. And the way R is starting, the R is starting from a pretty lower zone. The R is going into depth of the lower zone. And from that depth, it is coming up and it is forming R. So now, if you have this kind of S, this kind of R in the anywhere in the signature or in the writing as well, this will make you very sensitive to criticism, and that too in emotional area, because R is a representative of Rajput, which is this their surname. So again, this person will be very, very sensitive to criticism. It is difficult for this person to be, you know, to be normal when other people are talking bad about him or other people are talking good. It's like he will be sensitive. He will always respond. He will always talk about it. So this R, this kind of R where the loop is forming in this way will make you very, very sensitive to criticism. And the way R is forming right now, it's like the first thing is what he does is he takes the action and then he tries to cover those actions. So this is the action. This part is action. This is the manipulation. First, he has taken the action and then he has gone and thought about it. So without thinking, this person is going to take a lot of action. A lot of action just on the spur of the moment he will take. Because see, this is the action. This is the action part and this is the mental area. This is the thought part. So action will come first and then the thought will be there. And again, the ideas about ideas, this person will be very, very, sensitive. And the remaining part, like this T, is also announcing what we have discussed. This T is also showing that this person is, again, very, very sensitive to the mental criticism as well. This is for the emotional criticism. This is for the mental criticism, both where there is a formation of loop. And this loop indicates that person is being sensitive, being able to think a lot. And the remaining part, the way this Rajput has been written, it's not very clear. If you try to, he has tried to written it, you know his surname and that is how you can, you know, decode it, but it's not very, very clear. So what will happen in this kind of thing is this person now, well, it's like not he will not be very clear in his communication. So the communication part over here is bad. Communication part in the this signature is also bad. So somewhere because of this, and again, dot will prevent him from doing the communication with the people, and this dot will prevent him from doing the communication with the rest of the world. So it's like because of these dots, it's difficult for other people to approach him, and it's difficult for him to approach other people as well. So this is the kind of dots you must avoid if you are in the job where you are required to meet a lot of people, to mingle a lot of people. So, and unnecessary angles, unnecessary loops, this is called as threading. These all things are not very supportive for anyone who wants to have a very good and solid career. So this is what I wanted to share with you. And thank you very much for watching. I'm not seeing any other comments, any other questions. So great. Thank you very much for watching. And I have given you the indication of why to avoid the angles, unnecessary loops, unnecessary dots, and threading as well. So like, share, and comment, ask questions. I will be giving answers. And thank you very much for watching right now. See you soon. God bless you all. Bye. See you.